ಸೌರಾಶ್ರಯ ಸೋಮನಾಥಂ ಚ ಶ್ರೀಶೈಲೇ ಮಲ್ಲಿಕಾರ್ಜುನಂ ಉಜ್ಜಯಿನ್ಯಾ ಮಹಾಕಾಲ ಓಂಕಾರ ಮಮಲೇಶ್ವರಂ ಪರಲ್ಯಾಂ ವೈಜನಾಥಂ ಚ ಡಾಕಿನ್ಯಾಂ ಭೀಮಶಂಕರಂ ಸೇತುಬಂಧೇತು ರಾಮೇಶಂ ನಾಗೇಶಂ ದಾರುಕಾವನೆ ವಾರಣಸ್ಯಾಂತು ವಿಶ್ವೇಶಂ ತ್ರಯಂಬಕಂ ಗೌತಮೀತಟೆ ಹಿಮಾಲಯೇತು ಕೇದಾರಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣೇಶಂ ಶಿವಾಲಯೇ. ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ದ ಶಿವಪುರಾಣ, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸುಪ್ರಿಮಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್. ಟು ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ದೆಮ್, ಶಿವಾ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಎಂಡ್ಲೆಸ್ ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್, ದ ಜ್ಯೋತಿರ್ಲಿಂಗ. ವಿಷ್ಣು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟ್ ದಿಯರ್ ವೇಸ್ ಟು ಡೌನ್ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಐದರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಲೈಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್, ವೈಲ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಕನ್ಸೀಡೆಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಡಿಫೀಟ್. Shiva appeared as a second pillar of light and cursed Brahma that he would have no place in ceremonies while Vishnu would be worshipped till the end of the eternity. It is believed that Lord Shiva first manifested himself on earth on the night of the Aradra Nakshatra, thus the special reverence for the Jyotirlinga. The Jyotirlinga shrines thus are places where Shiva appeared as a fiery column of light. Originally, there were believed to be 64 Jyotirlingas, while 12 of them are considered to be very auspicious and holy. Saurashtra deshe visadeti ramye jyotirmayam chandrakalavatam sam bhakti pradanaya krupavatirnam tom somanatham sharanam prapadye. Sri Somanath temple enshrines the first of the 12 Adi Jyotirlingas of Lord Shiva. Sri Somanath Mahadev, located on the western Saurashtra coast of the Arabian Sea in the Verwal district of Gujarat, the moon god is said to have been relieved from the curse of his father-in-law Daksha Prajapati by the blessings of the Lord. This legendary temple known as the Shrine Eternal has withstood six repeated desecrations by the Muslim invaders and rebuilt several times by Hindu kings. This seventh existing temple is built in Chalukya style of temple architecture, reflecting the skills of Gujarat's master masons. The temple is situated at such a place that there is no land in a straight line between Somanath seashore until Antarctica. Such an inscription in Sanskrit is found on the Banastamba or the arrow pillar erected on the sea protection wall. ಶ್ರೀಶೈಲ ಶೃಂಗೇ ವಿಭತಾತಿ ಸಂಗೆ ತುಲಾದ್ರಿ ತುಂಗೆ ಮುದಾ ವಸಂತಂ ತಮರ್ಜುನಂ ಮಲ್ಲಿಕೂಪೂರ್ವಮೇಕಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಸಂಸಾರ ಸಮುದ್ರ ಸೇತುಂ. ಶ್ರೀಶೈಲಂ ಇಸ್ ಲೊಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನೂಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಂಧ್ರ ಪ್ರದೇಶ್. ಒನ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಸ್ ಚಂದ್ರವತಿ ವಾಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕದಲೀವನ ಇನ್ ದ ಹಿಲ್ಸ್, ಅ ಕಪಿಲಾ ಕೌ ವಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಅ ಬಿಲ್ವಾ ಟ್ರೀ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ವಾಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಅಡರ್ಸ್ and was sinking into the ground. This was the cow's routine chore every day. Chandravati dug up that area and found a Swayambhu Shivalinga. It was bright and shining like the sun's rays. She prayed at this Jyotirlinga and built a huge temple there. The Lord was very pleased with her. He went to Kailash wind-borne and attained Mukti. The presiding deities, Lord Mallikarjuna Swami is one of the 12 Jyotirlingas and Goddess Brahmaramba Devi is one of the 18 Mahashakti. Both are self-manifested and are in one place, which is very rare and only one of its kind. River Krishna is in the form of Patala Ganga. Devotees take holy dip and go for darshan of this Jyotirlinga. Avantikayam vihitavataram muktipradanaya cha sajjananam ಅಕಾಲ ಮೃತ್ಯೋ ಪರೀಕ್ಷಣಾರ್ಥಂ ವಂದೇ ಮಹಾಕಾಲ ಮಹಾಸುರೇಶಂ. ಮಹಾಕಾಲೇಶ್ವರ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೊಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿವರ್ ಕ್ಷಿಪ್ರ ಇನ್ ಉಜ್ಜೈನ್, ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶ್. ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಹಾಕಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಗಾರ್ಡಿಯನ್ ಪೇಟ್ರನ್ ಡೈಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ರೂಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೋಲಿ ಸಿಟಿ. ಲೆಜೆಂಡ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಅ 5-year-old ಬಾಯ್ ಶ್ರೀಕರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎಂಥ್ರಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡಿವೋಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಚಂದ್ರಸೇನ ಆಫ್ ಉಜ್ಜೈನ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಶಿವ. Shrikar took a stone and by considering it a linga started worshipping it regularly. Devotion of Shrikar increased by every passing day. Pleased by the boy's devotion, Lord Shiva assumed Jyotirlinga form and resided in the Mahakal forest. The temple is a three-tiered one with Lord Mahakal at the lowest level below the ground. At the middle is a temple of Omkareshwar and over it is a shrine of Nagachandreshwara. This shrine is open only on Nagapanchami day every year for a day. At the navel point of the earth south facing is Lord Mahakal, considered Dakshinamurti, is the only Jyotirlinga of its kind. Bhasma Arati is a grand elevating experience, one of its kind, which is done only in this temple every day between 4 to 6 a.m. by Naga Sadhus with sacred ash Bhasma. Mahakumbha Mela at Ujjain is conducted once in 12 years. Kaveri ka narmadayoho pavitre samagame sajjana taranaya sadaiva manda tripure vasantamokaramisham shivamekamide. The fourth of the Jyotirlinga, Omkaram Amaleshwara, is situated on the mountain Mandadatta on the banks of river Narmada in Malwa, Madhya Pradesh. Once Narada told Vindhya Parvat about the greatness of Mount Meru. This made Vindhya jealous of Meru and he decided to be bigger than Meru. Vindhya worshipped Lord Shiva to become greater than Meru by practicing severe penance. As a result, Lord Shiva was pleased and blessed him with his desired boon of growing, but took a promise that Vindhya will never be a problem to anyone. On a request of all the gods and sages, Lord Shiva made two parts of the lingas. One half is called Omkareshwara and the other Mamaleshwara or Amareshwara. This sacred island and the river are shaped like Om, and that is how it derives its name. The devotees who go around the temple are blessed because they are doing a parikrama of Omkara itself. The walls of Mamaleshwara temple contains the inscription of the Shiva Mahima Stotra dated 1063 AD. Purvotare Prajvalani Kadane Sada Vasantam Girijasametam Surasauradi Pada Padmam Shri Vaijanatham Tamaham Namami. Parali is in Bid district, Maharashtra. The presiding deity, Lord Vaidyanath, east facing with temple doors in the south and north directions. There is the legend from the Ramayana about Ravana halting here while on his way to Lanka with the Shivalinga. It is said that to be able to relieve himself, Ravana asked a herdsman boy to hold the Shivalinga for a while. However, the boy was unable to do so for long and placed it on earth, which is how the Jyotirlinga happens to be here. The belief is that Shiva decided to reside here in the form of Vaidyanatheshwara. It is believed that the temple belongs to the Yadava period that goes back to the 12th or the 13th century. This place defines the assimilation of the Shaiva and Vaishnava sects. Yam Dakini Shakini Ka Samaje Nishevyamanam Pishitashanaischa Sadaiva Bhimada Padaprasiddham Tam Shankaram Bhaktahitam Namami. Bhimashankara temple is on the Sahyadri hills near Pune, Maharashtra. Long ago, in the dense forests of Dakini, on the lofty ranges of the Sahyadris, lived the evil Asura by the name Bhima with his mother Karkati. The divine and the mortals were scared of him alike. But he was confronted by certain questions about his own existence which continuously tormented him. When Bhima could no longer sustain his agony and curiosity, he asked his mother to unveil the mysteries of his life. His mother revealed to him that he was the son of mighty Kumbhakarna, the younger brother of King Ravana of Lanka. Lord Vishnu in his incarnation as Lord Rama annihilated Kumbhakarna in the Great War. This infuriated Bhima vowed to avenge Lord Vishnu. He defeated a staunch devotee of Lord Shiva, Kamarupeshwara, and put him in the dungeons. He compelled and ordered Kamarupeshwara to worship him instead of Lord Shiva. When Kamarupeshwara refused to do puja to him, tyrant Bhima raised his sword to strike the Shivalinga to which puja and abhishek was being done. As soon as Bhima managed to raise his sword, Lord Shiva appeared before him. Then a terrible war began. Lord Shiva reduced the evil demon to ashes and thus concluded the saga of tyranny. Lord Shiva thus manifested himself in the form of Bhimashankara Jyotirlingam. It is believed that the sweat that poured forth from Lord Shiva's body after the battle formed the Bhimarati River.